So in this video, we're continuing with adding and subtracting algebraic fractions. This time, x is on the bottom. This is the second video with x on the bottom. Now, looking at this equation, you can see what the added complication is. In the previous video, we've had x on the bottom just by itself. This time, we have x plus 3 on the bottom here and x plus 2 on the bottom here. That's going to complicate things. Now, remember, when adding or subtracting fractions, make the denominator the same using lowest common multiple. So we have to make these denominators the same, with every other question we've done. Now the easiest way to find a common multiple, maybe not the lowest common multiple, but a common multiple, is to multiply one denominator by the other. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to take x plus 3 from our first one and multiply it by x plus 2 from our second one. That's multiplying this by this. Now remember, whatever you do to the bottom, you have to do to the top. So it's going to be x plus 1, and we're going to multiply that by whatever was over here, x plus 2. Minus, and then we do the same thing with our next one here. It's going to be x plus 2 times whatever this other one was, x plus 3. All over 2x minus 1, which is the top, multiplied by x plus 3. Okay, so a big hunk, lots of brackets here. Now, in all of the prior questions, once you've got the denominators the same, you can put it all over one fraction. And it's no different here. I'll just give myself a little more space. X plus 3, x plus 2. Now everything's going to go over that one denominator. X plus 1, x plus 2. Now there's this minus here. Now that means minus everything. So I'm going to put a big set of brackets around that. Minus 2x minus 1 times x plus 3. Now your next step here is to use the FOIL method to expand these brackets and expand these brackets. So first, x times x is x squared, outer, 2 times x is 2x, inner, 1 times x is 1x, which is just x, and 1 times 2, that's last, plus 2. That's those brackets expanded. And then we need to subtract everything in those brackets. So 2x times x is 2x squared. First, outer, 2x times 3 is 6x. Inner, negative 1 times x will be negative x. And last, negative 1 times 3 will be negative 3. And all of that is over our bottom, x plus 3, our denominator, x plus 2. Okay, starting to make some progress here. Now what we need to do, just realize that we've got minus everything in here. So that's going to be minus 2x squared, minus positive 6x, which is minus 6x, minus minus x, which will be positive x, and minus minus 3, which will be positive 3. So that's going to be x squared plus 2x plus x plus 2 minus 2x squared minus 6x, minus minus x, which is positive x, and minus minus 3, which is positive 3. All of that over x plus 3, x plus 2. Last step. Now that we've done all of this, we just need to group our like terms in our numerator. So you can see we have an x squared and negative 2x squared. X squared minus 2x squared will be minus x squared. Now we've got 2x, positive x, minus 6x. Where's our last x here? Where did I miss one? Ah. Minus minus x. Sorry, that should have been a positive x there. Okay. So we have x squared, negative x squared, Let's group our like terms with our x's. Positive 2x, positive x, negative 6x, and positive x. 2x plus x is 3x, minus 6x is negative 3x, plus x is negative 2x. Stay in the same color. And finally, we group our constants. We have a positive 2 and a positive 3. That's going to make positive 5. All over x plus 3, bracket, x plus 2. We can keep those in those brackets there. So there you have it. We've subtracted these fractions from each other.